So we're a little behind, so I'll try to expedite things. Plus, I'm having a little trouble with my foot here. I'm getting cramps. That happens sometimes when I do too much dancing and fasting at the same time. So this is a fast day for us Orthodox, and it will be broken at 7:16. That's when the moon rises, right? You want to keep it back? Those are questions for the minute. So, Om Gyan Tumaram Dasya, Gyanandana Shalakaya, Chakshurun Minatam Nena, Tasmai Shri Gurave Maha. I was born in the darkest of ignorance. My spiritual master, the Prophet, opened my eyes with the source light of knowledge. I offer humble obeisance unto him and all members of the Shri Gurave. So this is a very glorious day, and I feel very appreciative to everyone here and to the Prabhupada and the gods for allowing me to speak on this special occasion. I hope I can say something with fury. So I prepared a little something called the Gifts of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And those who know this verse, very famous verse, we can chant together. Namo Mahabhadanyaya, Krishna Prema Pradayate,
Krishna Prema Pradayate,
Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya,
Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya,
Namne Gaurakshe Namaha,
Namne Gaurakshe Namaha.
I offer my respectful obeisances unto the Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, who is more munificent than any other avatar, even Krishna himself, because he is bestowing freely what no one else has ever given, pure love of Krishna. And this is Srila Prabhupada speaking here. I didn't put down exactly where or when, but he has a little something on this, and I'm going to read this. Rupa Goswami called Chaitanya Mahaprabhu the most munificent, the most charitable personality, because he was offering the most precious thing of all very cheaply, love of Godhead. We all want Krishna and are all hankering after him. Krishna is the most attractive, the most beautiful, the most opulent, the most powerful, and the most learned. That is the object of our hankering. We're hankering after the beautiful, the powerful, the learned, the wealthy. Krishna is the reservoir of all of this. So we need only turn our attention toward him and we will get everything. Everything, whatever we want, whatever is our heart's desire, will be fulfilled by this process of Krishna consciousness. So Rupa Goswami, Srila Rupa Goswami, composed this verse, and he offered it to him when he saw Lord Chaitanya for the first time in Ram Kali, he and his brother Sanatan Goswami. And this is a very significant verse. First he says, Mahavadanyaya. The word dana is very common. That means a gift, a charity. So, but Vadanyaya means charitable or munificent. But Lord Chaitanya is Mahavadanyaya. He's the most munificent of all avatars. And Prabhupada would sometimes compare him to Krishna himself. Of course, he is Krishna himself. But Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita, he didn't just give out prema freely. He said, Sarva Dharma Vidityaja Mame Kam Saranam Vidya. He said, give up all dharmas and surrender unto me, or else. In the 16th chapter, he says, if you don't observe the Shastra and continue all your nonsense and acting according to your lusty desires, no perfection, no happiness, you can't go to the Supreme Abode. So Krishna made these conditions, and of course he's the ocean of mercy, but is a little different profile, so to speak. And he made these conditions, but Lord Chaitanya didn't make any conditions. He said, from any platform, anytime, you just come and chant Hare Krishna. Chant the holy name, Sankirtan. And the love of God will be bestowed upon you. Now we have this very wonderful book that Srila Prabhupada translated and commented upon called Chaitanya Charitamrita, which is the supreme biography of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. There are quite a few. There's at least 7 or 8 that are very famous. And the Chaitanya Charitamrita has a certain place because it gives not only the pastimes of the Lord, but also the philosophy very, very wonderfully. And Krishna's Kaviraj, and beautiful poetry, that's why it's called Kaviraj. So in that Chaitanya Charitamrita, you will find wonderful explications of how Lord Chaitanya met Rupa Goswami, and he instructed him, he met Sanatana Goswami and instructed him. And there is a nice summary of those teachings in the Madhya Lila especially. And it is through them that the whole philosophy has come. All the writings that we read, Srila Prabhupada's meticulous translations and commentations on the Bhagavad Gita, the Chaitanya Charitamrita, the Srimad Bhagavatam, Isha Upanishad, he based it on commentary by Rupa Goswami and Sanatana, or their followers, such as Baladeva Vibhushan, Jiva Goswami, who is also a student of Rupa Goswami, disciple. So, the philosophy that undergirds, that is the foundation of this Krishna consciousness movement, is all coming from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And that's why those who are orthodox, I guess, who offer their obeisances to Srila Prabhupada, Namaham Vishnu Padaya Krishna Vaisaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swami Namine, Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine, Yivishesha Shunyavati Padashya. Also very, very significant. Srila Prabhupada composed that second verse himself. There was no one else to do it in the 26th Second Avenue. And but it's very telling. Saraswati Devi, coming in the line of his spiritual master, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, showing that Srila Prabhupada is part of this parampara, or the cyclic succession, coming down from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu directly, and giving the same philosophy without distortion. And he's saving specific pastime to Srila Prabhupada, Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashya Desha Tarana, preaching the words of Lord Chaitanya, Gauravani Pracharya, Gauravani is the words of Lord Chaitanya. And thus, saving the Western lands, and of course as the movement grew all the lands, but he started in the West, here in America, from the impersonalism and voidism, especially. Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashya Desha Tarana. So, Lord Chaitanya, he gave this prema freely, but to enter into that mood, to achieve it, requires that we chant the Hare Krishna mantra purely. To get to that point is not so easy, the chanting of the name purely. And that's why there's a whole system, systematized by Rupa Goswami in his Nectar of Devotion and Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, that gives us the way in which we can progress step by step towards this purity by which we can actually experience the prema of Krishna, the love of Krishna, which is our natural state. In his teachings to Sanatana, Lord Chaitanya said, Nitya Siddha Krishna Prema, Sadhya Kabunoy, Shobhanadi Shuddha Chitte Kariya Yodoy, said every living entity, all of us, human beings, and even the lower animals, they're all living entities, spirit souls. We have as our natural state, because of love of God, Nitya Siddha Krishna Prema. Sadhya Bhuna, it's not something to bring in from outside. Simply by the, chiefly by the process of hearing and chanting, and chiefly by the process of hearing and chanting Hare Krishna mantra, in that the consciousness becomes purified, Shuddha Chitte, and Kariyayudra, it awakens. So this is why anyone from any background, any socioeconomic condition, gender, it doesn't matter. If you take part in the process and use your intelligence to practice it nicely, you will achieve the final result. So I'm going to detail a few of these gifts that Lord Chaitanya gave. As I was explaining, this, the main gift is prema, the love of God, which is so rare, we don't realize it. It's so rare. It's not like in bygone ages, everyone, even the great yogis and the rishis and the saints, were coming to this point of a love of Godhead. There's so many ways in which you can get away from that. Even if you're a great yogi and you're a great tapasvi, into a great practice of austerity. For instance, the yogis, they can practice austerity we can hardly even think of. Just what Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita. Can anyone really conceive of going alone, just like take off, go alone to the Himalayas somewhere, sitting down in a jungle or a cave, and doing what Krishna said, practicing the pranayama, drilling the respiration? You know? And even then, it's not that if you do it for 6 months or a year, you're sure to get prema. Because what happens is that you develop great powers. These yogic cities are real. You know, this becoming lighter than the lightest, astral travel. This is all real. So you can imagine if suddenly you have these powers, you can get anything from anywhere. Okay, Fort Knox, I'll use it for Krishna. But now you get so much gold, you say, well, all right, I'll just have to do it. There goes your prema. It's got to be all, everything. So what to speak of the impersonalist merging into Brahman or the materialist going up to heaven. You know, these are all Vedic processes, but they don't lead to prema. They lead to more attachment. You can be attached to the city. You can be attached to your reputation as a great renunciant. You know? So it's not so easy to get this prema, but Lord Chaitanya is giving it by this process of Harinam Sankirtan. So that's the first gift. And that's the second gift is the Sankirtan of the holy name. This is the means by which to attain the prema. And it's so powerful and so effective, and that's why we're sitting here. Because somehow or other, we experience the power of this chanting. We associate it with this movement, which is built on this. It's the Hare Krishna movement, after all. You know, we chant Hare Krishna. And as soon as you come into the chanting of some pure chanting, you can't be some just cinema song, you know, or something. And really, someone's chanting out of sincere, you know, devotion to Krishna. That will go deep into your heart. There'll be a change of heart. Even something you may not realize, but you become attracted and say, oh yeah, let's go there again. You know, and before you know it, you're coming on Sunday, and maybe even more. So he gives it the Sankirtan. Now Lord Chaitanya, every morning when we greet the deities, I have a routine. I have certain shlokas I chant for each deity. So the very first one is to Lord Nityananda and Lord Chaitanya. They're standing there. 7:15. So it's a beautiful meditation. It's the first verse in the Chaitanya Bhagavat. And it appears also at the beginning of the Madhya. Beautiful verse. I offer my obeisances unto Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda, whose arms reach down to their knees. This is a sign of great personality. Beautiful lotus eyes, golden complexion. Sankirtanaikapitaro, they are the fathers of the Sankirtan movement. When you read the Chaitanya Charitamrita and the Chaitanya Bhagavat, you'll see how it began in Navadvipa, in Mayapur. How Lord Chaitanya, when he began his Sankirtan movement, he had these old pastimes as a great pundit, and then he got initiated by Ishwar Purikin, and he started, and Nityananda came down. You know, it was really Balaram. Lord Chaitanya is Krishna, and Nityananda is Balaram. But they didn't show their divinity to everybody. It was all hidden. So then Nityananda and Haridas and the orders of Lord Chaitanya, they began preaching there. And what was the means of preaching? You know, very simple. You tell everybody, Bolo Krishna, Bhaja Krishna, Karo Krishna Shika. Just chant Krishna's name and worship him with all your heart. Follow his instructions and to others in impart. Simple. I'm going to do a little more. Not very good. And that was what they went around telling everybody. Please chant. And then Nityananda and Haridas Thakur, Namacharya, they would go around and they met Jagai Madai. And everyone said, don't go near them. Do not go near them. They're Brahmins. They're born in a Brahmin family, but they've totally fallen. They've become dacoits and drunkards and everything else. They just cause a disturbance. He said, these are the best candidates. These are representatives of the whole population of Kali Yuga. So if Lord Chaitanya, he saw himself as an agent of this, Lord Chaitanya can save these two, then his mission is assured. So I'm not going to tell the whole story. We did that in Nityananda's appearance day. We're not trying. But even at the cost of personal injury, Lord Nityananda kept preaching. Lord Chaitanya came, and at the urgings of Lord Nityananda, he delivered them, and they became pure devotees. Their entire sinful background was eradicated. And Lord Chaitanya warned his other devotees, don't think of them now as Jagai Madai, you know, as they were. They had a new name, a new life, and they became pure devotees. So that's, we're Jagai Madai. We can also get the same result by the same activity, which is to take Lord Chaitanya's lotus feet into our heart, to serve, to take up the process as it's been given so beautifully by Srila Prabhupada, who's following in the line. So the Sankirtan of the holy name is certainly a great gift. This is the gift, which leads to the original gift, prema. Then, but it's not just sentimental chanting and dancing. There's a deep philosophy to it. And this is what Chaitanya, as I mentioned, he taught Rupa, he taught Sanatan, he taught Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, Prakashananda Saraswati. These are all beautifully recounted in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. If you don't want to buy the full 9-volume set, just get the 1 volume of teaching of Lord Chaitanya, a few bucks. You know, this is one of Lord Chaitanya, of Srila Prabhupada's first books that he published in the West. And this is the book that really got me committed, you know, full of Lord Chaitanya's teachings. It's extracted from the Chaitanya Charitamrita, beautifully explained by Srila Prabhupada. So the philosophy given to Rupa Sanatana, Jiva Goswami, who's sometimes recognized by Westerners as the greatest philosopher who ever lived. He wrote these Shat Sandarbha. Shat means six philosophical treatises, all quoting so extensively from Bhagavad Purana and other Puranas, proving the basic tenets of Krishna philosophy, of Gaudiya Vaishnava philosophy. They're very, very, and now they're gradually being translated. My dear departed god brother Gopikaranandana Prabhu has given us the Shat Sandarbha, and the Bhagavat Sandarbha is also, I think, going to be produced soon. And Bhanu Swami has also given us the Shat Sandarbha. So if you want to read them, you can. What to speak of Srila Prabhupada's great gift of nectar of devotion, Rupa Goswami. Sanatana Goswami, Brihat Bhagavatamrita, which is the first book that the Goswami published, is now in a beautiful translation with commentary. So all of this philosophy is there in Prabhupada's books. As I mentioned, the purports are all based on the commentaries by these great acharyas. So we have unlimited access. All we need is the desire, the interest. This is the great injunction from the Vedanta Sutra. Atato Brahma Jigyasa. Vyasadeva is speaking to us. He's saying, now in the human form of life, you should inquire into the absolute truth, Brahman. Not just simply into the relative things of this world. You go on rotating millions and millions of births by that inquiry. But by the inquiry into who am I, what is this world, is there a God? If so, what is he or she doing? What is the relationship with this world? All of these different things. Lord Chaitanya's teachings answer all those questions beautifully. And not only that, so the other, now the gifts of Lord Chaitanya, these gifts of Sankirtan philosophy, they require what we call parampara, or disciplic succession. Because it's such a radical difference from the ordinary course of events. The Bhagavad Gita teaches us that the ordinary consciousness is fraught with what we call the modes of nature. Modes of nature, we all recognize, we may not know the name or that they are modes of nature, but we know people who are really driven to make a lot of money, to enjoy, to succeed in this world, right? Type A personalities, right? This is the mode of passion at work, you know? And it's not that they, you know, someone's in the mode of passion and there's no tinge of goodness, no tinge of ignorance. They're all mixed up. Sometimes those who are in the mode of passion also float up into the mode of goodness. They may ask, what am I doing? You know, some am I really going to succeed? Is this what I want to do? So there's some inquiry, there's some light, you know. And then you can also easily sink into the mode of ignorance, especially in this age, where the temptations are, come on, enjoy me. You know, the mind is so strong. And that ignorance means, you know, who cares about tomorrow? You know, how can I enjoy right now? Let's open up another beer. You know, intoxication, laziness, procrastination, dirt. You know, if we recognize some of those qualities sometimes in ourselves, they may rise up. You know? So these modes of nature, even the mode of goodness, can also bind one. So we're surrounded by this, especially the lower modes of passion and ignorance. If we don't take part in the process that is the calculating force for these modes of nature, then we're sure to be swept away and overwhelmed by them. And the very interest in spiritual matters, in ultimate questions of birth and death, of eternity, of God, and all these things, doesn't even arise. We're too absorbed in our material business. So, therefore, the parampara, the presence on this earth of realized souls who can personally give us association and inspire us to at least inquire, begin the process, rather than just stay mired in ignorance, that's another gift of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. By the parampara, meaning that to so infuse his own followers with the urge to preach, to spread the mission, not just to enjoy the prema themselves, it's easy enough, you know, for his followers, just go to Vrindavan and stay there and don't do anything. Now, the Goswami stayed in Vrindavan, but they wrote books, and those books went out of Vrindavan, and that's the foundation. That was their preaching. But to inspire the whole line coming down from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur, Narottam Das Thakur, Baladevi Vibhushan, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, Srila Prabhupada, and the followers, to take the mission to heart, and not just to write off this Kali Yuga as a lost cause, which is a temptation after all. Because, you know, you have your salvation. But Lord Chaitanya, he didn't do that. If you're really a follower, there has to be those two tracks. When you read the Chaitanya Charitamrita, the very, very beginning of the first chapter, there are these 14 verses called Mangalacharan, which we see any traditionally substantial literary work in Sanskrit and philosophical. They write these verses, introductory verses, that define the subject matter, that give blessings to the readers, that offer obeisances, like that. So we have these verses about Lord Chaitanya, the four verses there about him exclusively. And this morning we studied one of them, written by Rupa Goswami. So this is a verse in the Bhagavad-gita at the beginning. It says, for a long, long time, this prema had not been given. And not only prema, but at the highest level of Ujjvala Ras, means the mood of the gopis, especially Radharani for Krishna. This is what Lord Chaitanya specifically came to give. But now Lord Chaitanya, Shachinandan, has come. May he forever be situated in the innermost chambers of your heart, resplendent with complexion of molten gold. So he's giving it. In other words, this is the Sankirtan mission. And he, for 6 years, he went to South India. His basic preaching was chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Nam Sankirtan. And then he also went to Vrindavan, and he spoke to Rupa and spoke to Sanatana and gave his teaching there. He's preaching, he's spreading the knowledge also. So he took the trouble to start this parampara, and the followers of those great acharyas have come down. So that is also part of his gift, the fact that there are present on this in this world people who are serious bhaktas, who have received the love of Godhead, and who can teach it and give it to us. Without that, it would all be very theoretical. If Srila Prabhupada didn't come personally, but just send his books on the boat, what would happen? Nothing would happen. Yeah. I mean, the books, if they found their way into the library, we'd be lucky. But Prabhupada himself personified, he was the book Bhagavad and the person Bhagavad. He was the person Bhagavad. Bhagavad means in relation to Bhagavan. So that's another gift of Lord Chaitanya, inspiring from within the heart as the members of the descendants of the Goswamis and his own descendants of the Siddhic line to make the effort to keep pushing this movement on. And then one other gift that I was thinking of, the dhams, Mayapur and Vrindavan. It was Lord Chaitanya who went to Vrindavan when it was simply a forest, you know? And he found a little pond and he said, oh, this is Radhakund. Nobody knew it. Everything had been covered over. After all, he appeared about 500 years ago. So Lord Chaitanya, Krishna was 5,000 years ago. So in the intervening time, it had become covered over. I heard that, you know, it was used as a hunting ground. That the Muslims would go out there and hunt. So he himself found Radhakund, and he went to Govardhan Hill, and then he told Rupa Goswami and Sanatana, go there, one of your missions, not only writing, but to excavate the places of Lord Krishna's pastime. Those of us who are fortunate to have visited Vrindavan, you know, you go around and there's so many kunds, there's so many places, and this is Govardhan Hill. If you just see it as it is, it doesn't look like much of a hill to me. You know, it's a little ride. You know, this is Govardhan, it's the reason why it's so short. You know? So that's a great gift. What to speak of Mayapur, where he actually appeared. That's another great gift. Mayapur, Vrindavan, Nandakund. So these dhams where you can go and see the places where the pastime took place and actually remember, you know, and just take. The dhams have a special potency. These are now available. Now, Srila Prabhupada also, by his great efforts, he had that Krishnabalaram temple built and the Mayapur temple and the, you know, Dham is being built up. That was also part of what Chaitanya's mercy, that manifested by his pure devotees, to build up the Dham so that we can go there. And, you know, when I first went, there wasn't much. I camped out on the wall. Remember that wall? You know, like, within 2 days, or half a day, I was sick. I remember some of the things there, but a lot of it is like a hazy episode. But now it's in the accommodation, you know, you can go and be comfortable. So this is another great gift. And the final gift I wanted to mention to you was the ISKCON branch of the Chaitanya tree. You know, if, when you read the Chaitanya Charitamrita, I say when, hoping that you all will at one point. In the Adi Leela, there's several chapters describing the different branches of the Chaitanya tree. Lord Chaitanya is the great root, but there's a big branch coming from Nityananda, from Advaita, Gadadha, you know, going there. Prabhupada explained, this is, ISKCON is one of those branches, meaning that it's tied up to the root, and therefore it's being nourished. You know, now it's our responsibility to make sure that it doesn't get detached. In other words, to follow carefully and maintain the Dharma as Lord Chaitanya gave it. But this ISKCON branch of the tree, which is spread all over the world, you know, and is, of course, by the grace of the Srila Prabhupada and sincere followers. But the root is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And so we have a hint to thank for that. So those are some of the gifts of Lord Chaitanya. They're really infinite. Every one of the devotees who's sincerely following is also a gift to the world. We have the Sangha is everything. It's like this, you know, I come every day to the temple. I'm always there, you know, everyone will tell you. And we have our small little crew here, you know, chanting as sincerely as we can. But to have a festival with, you know, there's so many devotees, just to hear a kirtan with 100 voices in it is such a wonderful thing, you know. And so that's another gift. The places and the inspiration to come and chant Hare Krishna together, glorify the Lord, get His mercy, see the beautiful forms of the deities, and take Krishna prasadam, you know, which is another very important gift. You read the Chaitanya Charitamrita, chanting, dancing, and feasting. Prabhupada said, this is nothing but a process of recreation So that's very much prominent in Chaitanya Charitamrita, the chanting and the feasting. Krishna's Kaviraj was very learned. He was a great cook, too, and he has this one section where he goes preparation after preparation. Remember when Chaitanya took some half, and then they had the first alms? So this is kind of a little lasso jamdina, a little plain, you know, boiled sabzi, that's all. Meanwhile, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya's wife, Sita, was preparing this huge feast that they beautiful chapter 6. So these are some of the gifts of Lord Chaitanya. I wanted to end with a couple of poems that I wrote. I'm not going to read you the ashtakas. In Rupa Goswami, in his Sabamala, he begins with three beautiful 8-verse poems about Lord Chaitanya, each of which has a palashruti. Palashruti means the benefit of reading. So it's wonderful. If anyone wants it, just write to me. Jupiter108@gmail.com. I'll send you them all. But the first three, so one of them really inspired me because of the last line of each verse, which translates, O Lord Chaitanya, Sri Mukunda, Shachi's precious jewel, please shower your compassion on this wretched, stubborn fool. That's the last line of each. So that's when, the one I'll read you, one of those 8. Even low-born sinful souls entrapped in Kali's age, suffering uncounted pains that no one can assuage, are instantly delivered when you kindly seek them out and flood them with your splendid mercy, making bhakti sprout. And so with heart rejoicing at your mercy's endless store, I take full shelter of your lotus feet, and then implore, O Lord Chaitanya, Sri Mukunda, Shachi's precious jewel, please shower your compassion on this wretched stubborn fool. And one more, this is, I wrote 13 years ago. I worked with the BBT, we had a calendar that year, special calendar. They wanted me to write, instead of captions, poetic captions. So this is a caption for a painting of Lord Chaitanya, I forget which one it was, it's been so long. And it's appropriate for this day, because it describes Lord Chaitanya's appearance. In Brajadham, 5,000 years ago, Sri Radha worshipped Krishna without flaw. Along with all her gopi friends, she showed a love for God most pure and free from all. In Mayapur, 500 years ago, Sri Krishna came again to bless this age. This time, Sri Radha's role he took to show her love for him, which none can ever gauge. That golden avatar, Chaitanya Dev, with love of God through chanting of the name, the wise are grateful for the gift he gave, and tread devotion's path to spotless praise. And so we're back to the original gift. Any questions, comments? And this abbreviated little meditation on what you did. We have a question or a comment. Go ahead.
Thank you, Swamiji.
Hare Krishna. Oh, that was a comment. Thank you. I'm just trying to share a little bit of what I learned from Shiva. Yes, go ahead, Chris.
So, your disciplic succession goes back to Chaitanya, or does it directly go back to Krishna?
Well, Lord Chaitanya also, showing by as an Acharya, he also took initiation from Ishwara Puri, who was coming in the line called the Brahma Madhva line, going through Madhvacharya and Madhavendra Puri especially. And so, yes, the specific line goes all the way back to Krishna through Brahma. But Lord Chaitanya, who's Krishna himself, he brought a unique, Madhavendra Puri officially brought it, but Lord Chaitanya adopted it and reconciled all the different lines of Vaishnavism and really started his own Gaudiya Vaishnav Sampradaya. But we officially belong to the Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Vaishnav Sampradaya. You understand? So we do trace a line all the way back to Krishna himself, as do the other orthodox lines, the Rudra Sampradaya, etc. So you're right that it does go back to Krishna. But Lord Chaitanya is Krishna himself, so it's a unique aspect of the devotional service that he sees. The other sampradayas, they're Vaishnavas, there's no question. Lakshmi Narayan worship, you know. But they don't teach the supremacy, the ultimate supremacy of this conjugal love for Krishna, especially in the mood of Radharani and the gopis, Tarakiya Ras. This is an aspect of what Chaitanya teaches, we don't usually share, stuff that open form like this. But this is the unique thing. If you read Chaitanya Charitamrita, you'll understand. But what Chaitanya's Sampradaya is really unique, and that's why we say sometimes it's Gaudiya Vaishnava, going back to what Chaitanya.
And how far do you actually have names for your
sentence? All the way back. I can share with you. You read the Bhagavad Gita right in the introduction. At the end of the introduction, there's a list of the prominent members of the Sampradaya. And they start with Brahma and come all the way down. And the ones before Lord Chaitanya, you'll read Lakshmi Pati Chitta, Madhavendra Puri, and all that. So we do have names. We don't have so many details as our wives because we go back into the Middle Ages, what we call 1000 or 900 AD, like that. But we have the names. Thank you very much. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Now the question is, what should we do? Do you have a kirtan?
Yeah.
Do I have a little kirtan?
Yeah.
And then prasadam. It's okay to break the fast now. That's 7:16.